Women's Appreciation Month. Well, why do we celebrate Women's Month? Every year, March is designated Women's History Month by presidential proclamation. The month is set aside to honor women's contributions in American history. The Seneca Falls Convention was the first women's rights convention. It was held in July 1848 in Seneca Falls, New York. It launched the women's suffrage movement. The organizers included famous suffragists like Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Lucretia Mott. The goal of the convention was to discuss women's civic, social, and religious rights. They wrote a Declaration of Sentiments, a document parallel to the Declaration of Independence. It addressed abuses and assertions women have faced. The 19th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution granted American women the right to vote, a right known as women's suffrage, and was ratified on August 18, 1920, ending almost a century of protests.
It can't be done.
Well, let's change
first.
I'm a flyer pursuing my passion for the fun of it.
Amelia Earhart was born July 24, 1897 in Kansas. She is one of the world's most celebrated, being the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. During a flight around the world in 1937, she disappeared, but her whereabouts were never discovered to this day.
In the Rome Olympics, along with Wilma, almost the entire U.S. track team can...
She was phenomenal in the 1960 Games.
Wilma Rudolph, born on June 23, 1940, was a world record Olympist. She was known as the fastest woman in the world. When she was a child, she had polio and was told she would never walk again. Rudolph competed in the 1956 Olympics and won a bronze level. In 1960, she went back to Olympics and won 3 gold medals, broke at least 3 world records, and was the first woman to win 3 gold medals all in the same Olympics. Joko Tobe, born in 1939, was the first woman to climb the 7 summits and the first to summit Mount Everest. She started to love mountain climbing when she was only 10 years old. She joined a mountain climbing club and most of the time was the only woman there. So in 1969, she formed her own for only women. She summit Everest in 1975 and climbed all 7 summits by 1992.
Versus Wade is one of the most controversial decisions.
It's a case, but it's also a symbol.
In a landmark ruling, the Supreme Court today legalized abortions.
Roe versus Wade was a milestone decision of the U.S. Supreme Court in which the court ruled that the pregnant woman's right to choose to have an abortion without excessive government restriction was protected by the United States Constitution. It was decided on January 22, 1973. This allowed for all women in the U.S. to have full rights when choosing what to do with their body.
Woman, I can hardly express my mixed emotions at my thoughtlessness. After all,
Oprah Winfrey is an American TV show host, television producer, actress, author, and philanthropist. She is best known for a show called The Oprah Winfrey Show, which is one of the highest-rated television programs. She is considered the richest African-American of the 20th century and North America's first black multi-billionaire. Winfrey was the youngest and first black female anchor at WTVF-TV. In 1983, she relocated and hosted a low-rated show, which she took from last place in ratings to number one in ratings. Eventually, in 1986, the first episode of The Oprah Winfrey Show was aired.
story of this pen.
This is Breaking the Glass Ceiling.
Madeline Albright was born on May 15, 1937 in modern-day Sisig Republic. She was the first female Secretary of State and held a cabinet post from 1997 to 2001. She was named the ambassador to the UN in 1993. Albright played a big part in ending the Kosovo conflict. Serena Williams is an American tennis player who revolutionized women's tennis. She was born September 26, 1981 and is still alive to this day. She turned to professional tennis in 1995 at the age of 14. She has won more Grand Slam single titles, 23 of them, than any other during the Open era. She has played in Olympic Games around the world and won many gold medals. Danica Patrick is a former professional racing driver. Patrick is the most successful woman in the history of open wheel racing. Her first win was in 2008 at the Indy Japan 300. She is the only woman to win in an IndyCar series race. Sarah Fuller was born on June 20th, 1999 and is still alive to this day at the age of 21. She is an American college soccer goalkeeper and a college football place kicker for the Vanderbilt Commodores. She became a star on the soccer team as a senior in 2020 when she helped lead Vanderbilt to a conference tournament championship in the Southeastern Conference. She made women's history when she scored points in a Power 5 college football game, making her the first woman to ever do so.
After me. I, Kamala Davy Harris, do solemnly swear.
Kamala Harris is an American politician and attorney who is currently serving as the 49th Vice President of America. She made history in this past 2020 election by becoming the first female African American and Asian Vice President. She is currently the highest ranking female in U.S. history.